Who hasn't missed the Fringe in 2020? We certainly did. But fear not, Brighton Fringe, the largest multi-art festival in England and completely open access platform for events, will be back. This year, with new date, new look, but same great feelings. Put it in your diary and spread the word. Hashtag Celebrate Fringe from 28th of May until the 27th of June 2021. The registration are open to all, and ticket will be on sale from the 12th of April. I spoke with the director of the festival, Julian Caddy, to find out more.
The whole of the industry, the arts industry, and the Fringe in particular, have had a very difficult year. Brighton Fringe in May 2020 was forced to cancel, and we postponed it, therefore, to the autumn of 2020, and we ran a smaller Fringe, both live and online. And we decided to delay the start of Brighton Fringe until the 28th of May this year, and it'll be running from the 28th of May to the 27th of June. Registrations are currently open. We will be starting the tickets on sale in the middle of April. And we're looking forward to an exciting, challenging, of course, but I think a celebratory year of Brighton Fringe, because I think we really need it now. It'll be happening at a time when the restrictions will be relaxing, as we expect them to. We hope they will. So we may even see the last week of Brighton Fringe happening with no restrictions at all. So it's an important time for us to be there for the industry to remind people of what they've missed over this past year, and to, I think, give a good shot in the arm for an area of the economy that's really needed it.
Have you got any projection of what actually the Fringe this year might look like?
At the moment, it's impossible to say how big Brighton Fringe will be. We expect it to be smaller, of course. There won't be any of the international artists that we have come to expect and look forward. At the same time, a lot of Brighton Fringe, indeed at least a third of Brighton Fringe, is local anyway. So we are looking forward to receiving many more as a proportion of the overall festival from the local area. In terms of numbers, it's really difficult to say at the moment.
Is there a plan B?
Well, we have a lot of the programme which can be online, so whatever happens, there will be an online programme at Brighton Fringe, and we have, don't forget, already done a Fringe when there were restrictions in place. So during October and September and October and a little bit into November last year, we ran a socially distanced Brighton Fringe with nearly 90 events, and we received somewhere in the region of 12,500 attendances, both live and online. So the worst that I anticipate is that we will be in that sort of situation again. We are expecting more venues taking part, and indeed more artists, so we will be in a much better place, I think. We want to do two things really at the moment. We want to attract artists of all types to take part in Brighton Fringe. Just to bear in mind that all that we are doing within the Fringe is with a view to it happening safely. So all the venues are adhering to the rules in terms of social distancing and all of the other things that we come to expect as part of the ongoing restrictions. And if people aren't feeling safe about going to perform in person, then they can put on work online, whether live streamed or pre-recorded, or Zoom events, which is something which is quite common now. And the second thing is really for us to talk to our audiences, to know that Brighton Fringe wants to come back, but we do need your help and we need your support. And we really are grateful for the support of so many thousands of people who have come to Brighton Fringe events over the years, to know that you can become a friend of Brighton Fringe, you can donate, you can, I suppose, in the in the simplest sense and the most obvious sense, it would be to buy tickets for Brighton Fringe events when they come online in the middle of next month. Because we need your help. We need we need audiences to come, because most of the Brighton Fringe, and indeed the Fringe sector as a whole, is unfunded, and they've managed to get by, barely get by. And in a normal year they barely get by, but this year has been particularly hard. So I think now is the time more than ever for us to support something that we love and we really look forward to returning.